Hi everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel Blooming Biology. We are starting with the chapter number 1 of class 12th biology, which is reproduction in organisms. In this particular video tutorial, we will be discussing that what is reproduction, what are the differences in sexual and asexual reproduction, what are the different modes of asexual reproduction, and in the end we will be discussing about the process of fission. So let's get started. What is reproduction? As we all know that reproduction is the biological phenomena in which the organisms produce their young ones. The organisms act as parents and the parents produce young ones. We can also use the term offsprings for the young ones. So this is basically the process of production of young ones or children through parents, that is called as reproduction. So what is the purpose of reproduction? The first point is that the reproduction is necessary for the continuation of species. Just imagine a scenario that if a reproduction does not occur, then how can a species continue itself in an ecosystem? So reproduction is necessary for the continuation of species. Next is organization of population. As we all know that population consists of many kinds of individuals, like young individuals, adults and aged persons. So reproduction also helps in the maintaining the population or organization of a population. Next is variations. So reproduction plays role in variations also, that variations help in adaptations and further evolution. So if reproduction is not there, then variation, you won't be able to see the variations. And next is the life. As we all know that on Earth, life exists only because of reproduction. So this is the purpose of reproduction. And now we will be considering that what are the basic features of reproduction. So these are the features that are common to all kinds of reproduction. First of all, the synthesis of RNA, protein and biochemicals will occur, and in the next step, replication of DNA will occur. After the replication of DNA, the cells will start dividing and proper cell division will occur, which will form the newly formed cells. And once the newly formed cells have been formed, the growth of the cells will occur, and in the next stage, there will be the formation of reproductive units on those newly formed cells or the cells that have been matured. After the formation of the reproductive units, the formation of new individuals occur from these reproductive units. So this is the complete pathway through which the reproduction in all kinds of organisms takes place. So you have to remember that replication of DNA is the important step, cell division and the formation of reproductive units. And then from the reproductive units, the newly individual cells will be formed. Now we will be considering that what are the different kinds of reproduction. Reproduction consists of two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. In asexual reproduction, there will be the involvement of a single parent, while in case of sexual reproduction, two parents will be involved. In asexual reproduction, there will be no need for the formation of gametes, while the gametes are required in the sexual reproduction. So this is the complete flowchart. You have to remember both the kinds of reproduction and what are their features, that in which kind of reproduction gametes are required and in which kind of reproduction gametes are not required. Now these are the different kinds of asexual reproduction. Here you can see the first one is the fission, budding, fragmentation, gamete, regeneration, spore formation and the vegetative propagation. So we will be discussing each one of them in detail. In this video tutorial, we are discussing only about fission. In fission, what happens? The parent body is divided into two parts. It gets segmented to form two parts, which further form two daughter individuals. Here we can see, suppose this is the parent body. it will get divided into two parts. First one and the second one. So these two will be the individuals. So these two are the two daughter nuclei. So fission is the division of the parent body into two or more daughter individuals identical to the parent. So remember, in fission, the individuals that are newly formed daughter nuclei will be identical to the parent. So fission is further of three types: binary fission, multiple fission, and plasmotomy. You need to remember all the examples of a particular type of fission. For example, simple binary fission occurs in amoeba, longitudinal binary fission occurs in euglena, transverse binary fission occurs in paramecium planaria, and oblique binary fission occurs in ceratium. Similarly, multiple fission occurs in amoeba and plasmodium, which is a malarial parasite, and plasmotomy occurs in opalina and pilomyxa. Now we will consider that how simple binary fission occurs. The example here we have is for amoeba. The simple binary fission, here you can see the structure of amoeba. It consists of a contractile vacuole and a nucleus. The plane of division can pass through any plane. So first of all, the nucleus will get replicated, the DNA will get replicated, and the cell division will start. So here you can see the various stages of the cell division, like prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase. Up to here, the cell division has been completed and the two daughter amoebae has been formed. Here, the parent body is divided into two parts after the replication of the DNA. So, the plane of division can pass through any plane. Now, coming to our next type, which is longitudinal binary fission. In longitudinal binary fission, the plane of division passes through the longitudinal axis. So this is the longitudinal axis. Here you can see the longitudinal furrow. So the plane of division will also pass through the longitudinal furrow. Example we have here is of euglena. Here you can see the parent body is getting divided to form two daughter nuclei or two daughter euglena. The plane of division is through the longitudinal furrow. The nucleus is getting replicated and one nucleus is transferred to one daughter nuclei and another one to another daughter nuclei. Now coming to the third type of binary fission, which is the transverse binary fission. So here the plane of division runs along the transverse axis. So this is the transverse axis and the plane of division will pass through the transverse axis of the body. Example we have here is paramecium and planaria. Here you can see there is one micronucleus and a macronucleus, and they got divided through mitosis process, and one nucleus is transferred to the upper one and the second one is transferred to the lower one, and two daughter paramecium has been formed. Similar is the case for the transverse binary fission in planaria. Here you can see the parent body is getting divided into two daughter cells through the process of fission, in which the transverse binary fission is taking place because the plane of division is passing through the transverse axis and not through the longitudinal axis. So in case of planaria and paramecium, there will be the transverse binary fission, and in case of euglena, there will be the longitudinal binary fission. Now coming to the multiple fission in amoeba, you should note that when amoeba is in the normal state, then it has pseudopodia around its cell. So, but when the amoeba gets into an unfavorable condition, it just withdraws its pseudopodia and it secretes three-layered cyst wall around itself. Here you can see the three-layered cyst wall around the nucleus, which is called as a cyst wall, and the process is called as the encystment. But When the favorable conditions come back again, the nucleus starts dividing through the multiple fission and it secretes a number of daughter nuclei after the replication of the nucleus. So what happens? A number of daughter amoebae are formed inside this cyst, and during the favorable conditions, these cyst wall gets ruptured and the new amoebae are released into the environment. So the process is called as the sporulation. When the amoebae are getting released into the environment, that is called as sporulation, and it occurs during the favorable conditions, while the cyst wall formation or encystment process occurs during the unfavorable conditions. Now our next example for studying the multiple fission is the Plasmodium, which is a malarial parasite. Here you should consider that when the malarial parasite, that is Plasmodium, when it is present in the stomach of female Anopheles mosquito, then it is called as oocyte. When it is present in the Anopheles mosquito, okay, but when it is present in the liver of a human, it is called as schizont. So you have to remember these two terms, that is oocyte and the schizont. Schizont is present in the liver while oocyte is present in the female Anopheles mosquito. If the multiple fission occurs in the oocyte, then the daughter cells which will be produced after the multiple fission will be called as sporozoites. And the whole process will be called as sporogony. Okay, but when the schizont, the another form of Plasmodium malarial parasite, when it gets multiple, when it undergoes multiple fission, it will form merozoites. And the whole process will be called as schizogony. So I will repeat the whole process again. If the Plasmodium malarial parasite is present in the Anopheles mosquito, then it will be called as oocyte. But when it is present in the liver of the man, it will be called as schizont. If schizont undergoes multiple division, it will form merozoites. The process will be called as schizogony. And if the oocyte undergoes multiple division, it will form sporozoites, and the process will be called as sporogony. Now here we can see that I have drawn here the schizont stage, which is basically present in the liver of the human. So when the nucleus of the schizont stage divides, it forms multiple nuclei and daughter nuclei are formed, and a cyst wall that is around the cytoplasm, it gets ruptures and all the merozoites will be released. So this is how the infection of Plasmodium occurs in humans when it is present in the liver. But when it is present in the Anopheles mosquito, it will be in the form of oocyte, and the process will be called as sporogony to produce the sporozoites. So I hope your concept of multiple fission is clear. If you have understood the concept, do like, share and subscribe to my YouTube channel Blooming Biology. Thank you for watching this video.